Today I want to show you something, a way to approach things when your subject matter might be a little bit more difficult than you're comfortable doing, or seems a little bit more challenging than what you've done before. Sometimes you can just do part of something. In my opinion, one of the hardest things to paint, especially in the beginning, is a string instrument. There's a lot of ridges, there's the fingerboard, there's all kinds of stuff. And every single one of them has perspective and is a challenge. But they're beautiful. So today we're going to take a look at a violin, but we're just going to take a look at a section. And that section's going to teach us a little bit of technique and enough that in a video that's going to follow this one, not immediately after, we'll do some practice in between. We're going to do the full violin, and you'll feel a lot more comfortable tackling it because you'll know a little bit about how to handle certain elements. So we're going to just do a partial side profile, okay? And there's a few things in there that are going to help us show that it's a violin. The chin rest. Right, and then I'm gonna put I'm gonna put some details in, and we're not even gonna do the fingerboard or anything. We're just gonna focus on this little part. And actually, let me draw that in a little bit better so you can see it. So one thing this is teaching us today is to learn how to make something look like it's laying down, which isn't always as easy as it sounds. So you want to make sure that your curves are long, but they also go in and up and down when needed, and back. Okay. And we're going to adjust that a little bit because I know that's not quite right. I just want to go about where it's going to go. So I make sure I leave that section open. Okay. So we're going to start with a number 2 flat brush. And we're going to do this in sections. We're going to do this side. Just get this part wet. And then I want you to leave a white area right there. Next section, leave a white area right there, and the section after. We're gonna put the paint down fairly quickly. I like adding quite a bit of color to mine, so I rarely just use a brown. But I'm gonna start with the Van Dyke brown base, and I'm gonna add some red to it. And we need a lot more paint than that because we want it to really flow. Getting better. Getting better. See how it's starting to bleed out a little bit? Now, while it's wet like that, is when I want to start to add those reds. I might even add a little bit of pink. I like to make things more colorful than they are. I think that's one of the beauties of painting something, enhancing it. I'm going to collect a little color at the bottom. Remember, I didn't make this part wet first. So I have a little bit more control over it. I'm gonna tip it up because I like when something's this loose to create a couple of drips. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back in and put some more detail into it so it stays nice and loose, but there's some rhyme or reason to it. You still want someone to know it's a violin. That color on the bottom that I threw in there, that blue, that's a cerulean blue, which is like a sky blue. I'm gonna add it right there too. Another purpose of this video is to show you that you don't always have to have something be the color that you assume it should be. Sometimes it can be vibrant, sometimes it can be really, really dull. It's up to you. Did I make a huge plan of what colors I was going to put in here? Clearly not. But I'm fine with it. This is a piece with a little bit of mood to it. So is that enough of violin to know it's a violin? I think so. Where we were really loose with the water and things bled together a lot, after this dries, we can go back in and put a little more tightness to it. I can actually probably do most of it right now. There, like that. Get rid of those frayed edges. And if this is your first loose painting, congratulations. It's not easy to kind of let go like this. So good job.